You are known for your excellent advice about specifically getting picky eaters to try new foods. A lot of us have at least one of them. Can you share some ideas to support a child who is especially resistant to trying new foods?
Sure. I love helping kids try new foods, but it is an art, it's not a science, and with any type of new food, I think we have to remember that there are two motivators for children in terms of trying new food. It has to look good, and it has to taste good. And kids love flavor. So our job, again, as parents, to expose them to a lot of different flavors. And we can do that by preparing seafood using extra things like herbs and spices. Soy sauce, that was a great vehicle for my children. They love soy sauce. They love to dip in soy sauce. But even like, I used to use Redfish Magic on salmon. Had a little bit of spice, just a little bit of kick, but I would put it on very lightly for my children, just to give it a new flavor. So there are lots of ways of, you know, building flavor around seafood. And I think that parents should never be afraid of flavor. You never know what your child is going to like. They might like the sweet things, like a honey glaze on salmon, or they might like more spice, which surprises parents, but some children do gravitate towards those spices. So I encourage parents to prepare them with a lot of different flavors. And then the other thing is make it look good. So, you know, you can chunk fish, you can skewer it, you can put it in a taco or a quesadilla. There are lots of different ways. Make a bowl, a fish bowl with rice and vegetables. There's lots of different ways that you can showcase seafood, and I would encourage parents to push themselves a little bit out of their box of the way they think it should be served and try to get a little creative with that.
Mm-hmm. My kids really love citrus. So I will do just a bowl of lemon wedges on the side of fish, and they absolutely love to squeeze that on top, and I think oftentimes they're trying the fish just so they can participate in squeezing lemon on top.
That really highlights the autonomy of eating too, and I'll just throw that in. Anytime you can let your child participate in that meal and eat for themselves, like you don't have to actually feed them or do a lot for them, that they can, you know, dip themselves, or like you said, squeeze lemon, or even serve themselves, you know, really brings that autonomy factor into it, and kids love to be autonomous. They want to do it themselves.